हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश रोटीन क्लासेस, एक्सरसाइज 13। गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन, स्टार्ट। सर, ए टाइम हैज़ कम व्हेन वी शुड रिकंसीडर एंड रिवाइज आवर एटीट्यूड्स टुवर्ड्स द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड एग्रीकल्चरल डेवलपमेंट। इफ एग्रीकल्चर डज नॉट डेवलप, आवर कंट्री कैन नॉट make any progress and we can neither become an agricultural power in the world nor we can become an industrial power. Sir, there are large potentials in our country to become an agricultural power in the world and we can not only meet our own requirements but we can also be one of the major exporting countries in Asia. For this purpose, it is necessary for recasting the priorities and also for a proper allocation in budget. Sir, only rupees 200 crores was budgeted for rural employment. It is a very small figure and it cannot even give employment to a few thousands in the rural side. The allotment for irrigation and other purposes is also not sufficient. But, sir, in order to give proper emphasis to the department, in my opinion, it is necessary to have a separate budget for the agriculture ministry as we are having for the railways. I do not know why a separate budget has been provided for the railways, although traditionally this system is being followed. But for agriculture, on which 70 to 80% of our population depends and which is the major stay of our economy, there is no separate budget. It should be given the pride of place and we should have a separate budget for agriculture. Similarly, there is no reason why the Department of Cooperation should be tagged on to the agriculture ministry. The report itself says that it is a very important aspect of our making progress in every department of life, be it industry, cooperative, marketing or any other sphere. The report says that the cooperative movement in the country has been considerably expanded during the last about 55 years, that the activities of the cooperatives now cover different sections of the economy, more especially agricultural credit, marketing, processing, storage and distribution of agricultural inputs and also consumer goods in rural areas. It goes on to say that the value of operation of all types of cooperatives is estimated to exceed rupees 1600 crores, involving over million members. But, sir, the report says that the managing committee of large number of cooperative societies in the states were superseded by the government. Sir, it is necessary to have a separate ministry for cooperation if we really want that this cooperative movement is to become successful. I therefore suggest through you, sir, that the government should seriously consider having a separate ministry for cooperation. Sir, cooperative movement is spreading all over. Incidentally, I would like to say that even the workers' cooperatives in the newspaper industry are given a raw deal. In my place, there is a workers' cooperative running a newspaper, but even they are not getting all the facilities. Therefore, if we really want to reach the commanding heights of production, which is our objective, it is necessary that the workers' cooperatives are promoted, and for that purpose, my suggestion is that there should be a separate Ministry of Cooperation. Then, sir, this report contains a catalogue of events. The report says that in 1995, the major cause of severe setback to agricultural production was unprecedented drought in 1995-96. And when it comes to how we have made progress in 1996-97, it says because the weather was comparatively fair and there was no drought to that extent. What is the achievement we have made? Therefore, the whole report is very disappointing. It does not disclose what all the radical changes have taken place or what steps have been taken to improve agriculture with expedition. And from point of view, if you really examine this report, you will find that the government has not taken major steps about land reforms, about rural employment or the integrated rural development program. For that purpose, a separate department was constituted for rural reconstruction, and the ministry in this report admits that benefits of investment on agriculture have not reached poorer sections of rural population. The report begins like this. It was felt, therefore, that exclusive special programs for the exclusive benefit of poorer sections of rural population are required if the objective of distributive justice was to be achieved, and then after giving the number of agencies which are working, the report has not revealed what rural employment was given in the year 1995-96. I would like to know from the minister, in view of investment and so many programs of integrated rural development going on, what was the increase in rural employment in the year 1995-96. The report itself is astonishing in another aspect. It says that land reforms are being implemented, but the land reforms implementation paragraph in the report is interesting. It is only the lipsympathy which has been shown by the government.